Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs us of something very important. You see the clothing we are wearing today? MashaAllah. Who gave it to us? It's Allah. He gave it to us so beautiful, it covers our private parts. And it covers us in a way that really we become people who are spiritual. This is why Allah warns us regarding clothing. Dress not only appropriately, but properly. May Allah grant us goodness. And may He make us such that whenever we come to the house of Allah, we take pride in our dress because we are coming to the house of Allah. Imagine, the house of your maker. Today, if you had to go to the house of a top businessman, multimillionaire, or top politician, what would we do? We'd make sure we have a bath. We'd make sure we are wearing good clothing. We'd make sure we have proper perfume. And we'd make sure that we are looking decent. And we look in all the mirrors before we get there. And we make sure last minute everything is okay. You know, we put out everything straight and nice. MashaAllah, this must be straight. That must be straight. My pen must be in order. My watch must be in order. My schooners, my shoes must be fine. MashaAllah, everything should be okay. May Allah protect us and grant us goodness. Brothers and sisters, what about the house of Allah? We pitch up really to the house of Allah and we don't even know what we're wearing. Wallahi. And we don't even take pride in it. So Allah says, Ya Bani Adam, khudhu zinatakum 'inda kulli masjid. Verse number 31 of Surah Al-A'raf. O children of Adam, take pride in your dress when it comes to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا. And eat and drink. وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا. Do not waste. When you are wasteful, your peace is snatched away. Why? Because you become extravagant. You are setting a trend. So wastefulness is also from the devil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And this is why Allah says, Ya Bani Adam, qad anzalna alaykum libasan yuwari sawatikum warisha. ولباس التقوى ذلك خير. O children of Adam, we have sent down to you beautiful clothing. We have sent down to you beautiful clothing in order that you may cover your private parts and beautify yourselves. But remember, the clothing of piety is indeed better for you. This has two meanings. One is, when you wear your clothing, make sure there are clothings of piety. The clothing is that of goodness. Not only does it cover you, but properly. You know, if it's too tight, it's not correct. It will result in some form of downfall. We always say, when people do not dress appropriately, wallahi, my mothers and sisters, you end up paying for it. Why do we want to do that? Imagine, you end up paying for it. So just dress appropriately, properly. He who is attracted to you because you showed perhaps your legs or your shape, those legs are not going to look like that for the rest of your life, nor are you going to be maintaining that shape after you've delivered two children. So therefore, it's better for you not to do that, to realize that he who is attracted to your heart and your goodness and your character and your deen is the one whom, no matter what you look like, he will love you and adore you. And 60 years down the line, he'll tell you, honey, you're the one. Allahu Akbar. It's a reality. We are losing track because we want to dress with tight clothing. We want to do this. We want to undress and attract people. And the day you don't have hair anymore, they don't want to look at you. Why? Because I was attracted to that hair that was really, you know, blowing in the wind. Where is that gone? Well, Allahu Akbar. I'm now a Muslim and I want to be really obedient to Allah and put on my scarf. My sister, did you wait for you to become bald before you put on your headscarf? Allahu Akbar. May Allah grant us inner peace and outer peace. May He make us dress in such a way that those spouses that are the best for us are the ones who are attracted to us. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters, what powerful words. May Allah grant us goodness. So remember, when you dress appropriately, yes, it will attract the right people to you. Your company will be correct. When you want to dress inappropriately, the same clique of people who have that type of life will be your company. May Allah protect us. Grant both the men and the women goodness today. The women, yes, we speak about them, but the men are as guilty. We have now developed what is called, very sadly, half bummers. They're halfway down your backside. And really, you see people coming to the masjid for Jumu'ah and they engage in sujood. And we are standing behind and we just don't know what to do. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi, it's happening, my brothers and sisters. So let's not only address the women folk when it comes to dress code, but the men. Remember, tight clothing prohibited for men also. Did you know that? And you are supposed to be dressing properly, appropriately. May Allah grant us goodness. Let's move a little bit further. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us. In fact, there is one point I did not yet make mention of, and that is, if you are to be a person who is conscious of Allah, then even if your clothing is slightly tatty and so on, believe me, you will have honor and dignity in the eyes of people. When you are upright and your character is beautiful and amazing, remember, one is to wear clothing that people can see in terms of the cloth that you are putting on. And two is your character. Your character beautifies you, even if your clothing is not that beautiful. And your character can actually drop you and make you the ugliest person on earth, whom nobody wants to talk to, even if you're the don, according to the dress code that you have. Yes, believe me, you might have something really put on that is state of the art, maybe perhaps designer of this nature or that. But if your character stinks, believe me, people will have to block their noses as they walk past. May Allah protect us. My brothers and sisters, there is a lot that we will say. Inshallah, we'll leave it for tomorrow until we meet then again. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdi. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayki.